has said, listen, exactly everyone knows like I want this fight.
I don't know if it's really his game
90% of the people here were cheering for Lopez coming out.
Should I never let him fight?
Was it a mistake to fight?
It was the greatest choice I ever decided to do in my life.
Almost died.
Good.
Father God, thank you for everything. Thank you for bringing us all here. Team Legendary Vibes for the champ. We went through a whole camp just for you. God the glory in everything we do. We love you, we cherish you. We ask you to protect over champ, give him the strength, the wisdom to make the maximum version of himself. Let him go out there and be him. Let him float out there. Let him move like water. Please continue to watch over everybody in his corner. Give them the strength, the protection, and the wisdom to execute. Please, Lord, continue to bless us. We thank you in advance. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Let's get it, baby.
So I would say a couple of things. As you get older, it's going to be more and more difficult and less healthy to cut. So I do think you want to, you don't want to cut all the way down to the 135.
I'm out of that.
That's smart. And you've won that. You've done everything you can do there. You did everything you could do. You accomplished. Listen, that story's over and done with. You climbed the top of the mountain. You put your flag in the peak. There's not more you can do. Move on to another challenge. You did everything you could do there. There's nothing more you could do there. So now we move on to the next.
Okay. From a medical standpoint, I'll tell you. So you had a pneumomediastinum, which means is there's air that dissects around the esophagus, around the windpipe, the trachea, the pulmonary parenchyma, the lung. And there's no evidence of any injury. The esophagus looks good on the double swallow, on the CT scan, the airway looks good, the lung looks good. So this is all fine. I'm going to clear you to fight. That's really not an issue. I want you to examine your neck.
All right, so when's the next fight?
August 13th.
All right, good.
In Las Vegas.
All right, okay. I think he's great. Yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing him. Well, August 13th.
August 13th.
All right, I'll be watching, man. I'm looking forward to it. I'll be one of the many people who cheer
for you.
All right, God bless you. You're a good man.
Who am I? You know, who am I to the people? You know, I have a kid now, like I said before. Honestly, it's just that fatherhood time. You know, I haven't yet spent much more time with my son as I would want to. And he'll understand that as he gets older. If I can see, like, how can I change and how can I give my son more knowledge rather than luxury things, then I'm gonna do that. You know, and the take back is really just about inspiring others like we always do. And grabbing everything, becoming a two-time undisputed world champion, breaking history, making more records, doing things that people have yet to see. And I'm just grateful to even be here, honestly. I just say to God, I need your help here. Because I'm about to do something that you know I'm not built to do, and that's quit.
Been waiting for, man.
working on drills, foot drills, hand-eye, reaction, everything. You know, my guy, TA, Goldfeet Formula, that's what's about to happen right now. I'm about to enter the whole matrix.
Start off with a warm-up, get the glutes, the hips activated, then work on some neuromuscular activation, footwork drills that translate directly to boxing, start getting some resistance sprints, get the fast twitch muscles going. Yeah, legendary vibe.
You know, a wise man once said, it takes a village. So we actually are being a team. There's no ego involved in it. There's no one that's better than anyone. We're all learning and we're all just growing together. Where we're about to go, not a lot of people can, and the ones that are here with me right now are the ones that God sees are able to go. You know, and I'm grateful that God has planted those people in my life and those seeds, because it's only gonna make us greater and bigger, because where we're heading, not a lot of people can go.
That's your money punch.
Man, my unit, my team, this new team, psh, y'all ain't ready. Legendary vibes, let's go.
It is a fucking game!
My father, though, is the one that really, he knows me best. He's seen me at my worst, he's seen me at my best, you know, and he's going to be the one that definitely is going to tell me the things that I really need to focus on how can I beat this guy. I trust him. I trust him with my life.
It's the first minute. It's gonna break. The first minute hurts.
And I just want everyone to see that, you know, my father didn't become Trainer of the Year just by luck, you know, in 2020. You know, we beat the most decorated fighter pound for pound during that time, Vasily Lomachenko. That was from him. You know, he told me how the game plan had to go.
And he'll push him and he'll freaking just try dogging him. But he's trained for that. He's trained to keep on doing that every round. So when he spars,
he's trying to make everybody tired.
So when he spars, I tell him, okay, you could box.
Yeah.
You could box, but what's gonna happen when you can't box no more, you get tired of it and you feel that guy's weight.
Yeah,
You know, you gotta get adjusted to that. So when he's sparring this dude that comes just forward, I tell him, let the dude come to you. Let him be on your body. Let him be on your body. So you can get used to that body. So in the fight, when the guy comes on his body, he'll be strong enough to push him away from him.
So I just really want to give my father his flowers, especially for this fight. Let them be known to everyone out there that man is always going to be in my corner. And if anyone got something to say about it, you can meet me. You can meet me in that ring.
So like you know, we already here, fight week is on, and we at the UFC facility center. I've never seen him this great since right after the Olympics when he turned pro. And very explosive, but now it's a take back, and we just trying to focus on that and going to the next level, man, and taking over the 140 weight division, and that's what we focus on right now.
Color peacock, thugging in my Reebok. Cut the dreads and relock. Buck the feds, I buck the feds. You buck the feds and link up. I'ma see but my diamonds be cut. Gotta despise a free lunch. I don't want nothing free. Bring me a Cardi B.
Wow.
Big name Cardiac, bigger than harder match. I whipped me harder back. I took every loss, I knew I was gon' win for the battle. Young nigga with the crazy crew, they think he playin' with the devil.
So when he comes here, when he comes here, go to the body. When he comes here, go to the body. Esa! Oh, beautiful, beautiful.
He can't touch it, champ. He can't touch it, champ.
45 seconds. 45 seconds. Let's go.
That's lightweight. Let's go.
I'm winning.
Is this that a lot of people don't kind of quite, you know, want to really take into consideration or take into themselves because so much ego that gets involved. Is this, you guys all talk a lot, but where is your work ethic? Where is your stuff at? I mean, shit, that's why we are separate. There is a yin and there is a yang, you know what I'm saying? And that's why I was blessed enough, and not even that, I worked my ass off to get to where I'm at today, you know? The people that talk down on all of us is because they never did shit in their life, and they want to bring everybody down. Look, negative vibes, man, they try to bring you around because they got nowhere to go. You know, positive vibes, they know where they're heading. They know where they're going. So it's all about pushing that needle, man, and putting my foot on everyone's neck and holding it. This time we're gonna cut the head.
This kid dances in there. This kid does things that I have ever seen. And it's not because he's my son. You know, maybe people were like, oh yeah, he has to say those things. That's his son. But you know, come Saturday night, he's gonna bring excitement. I mean, that was the worst fight that he's ever done. And it was nominated for Fight of the Year on his worst day. Because he comes to give it all. You know, to the world, to the people. You know, he's willing to give up his life.
Just blinged out. Are you happy with it?
Really?
Oh, man,
got my carnelian stones here, so
he's all the elements and everything.
Yeah. Oh.
Wow.
Love it. Oh,
the details on this.
Yeah, shout out to Fight.
It looks really
Fight Label. Shout out to Sophie. She be killing it every time. She don't ever disappoint. It's fight night. Today's the day. Today we shocked the world once again, letting it be known to your females here. It's just making my mark, you know, getting a haircut. Gotta feel good, you know. Gotta look good, so that way I fight great. Like, tuning everything out. You know, a couple hours left to basically have fun, you know. I'm gonna have fun tonight, really, and just do the best that I know I can do. Mm-hmm. And it's all grace and all glory to God. You know, as we get into the locker room and as I get into that stage of like hearing the bells and the fighters and hearing people like scream and stuff, I already know it's coming close. So I have to really like remind myself, this is it, this is war, you know, this is nothing, there's no coming back from this, you know, this is make it or break it. You know, everything I trained my life for, 21 years in this, you know, and this today is really where it sets the pace and tone for where am I gonna head after this. You know, so it's not hard. It's not hard to really focus on that. You know, that's it. Like the Black Mamba, all those things. You know, that's it. Now this is where my lion comes out. I'm coming out that cage. You know, so just zoned in, focused, hungry, ready for anything and everything, and just gonna perform at my greatest. Give everyone an eye candy performance. See what this guy can do. You know, and we'll perform the way we do.
Open? Yeah, it's supposed to be in the top. Just make sure when they wrap, they don't go like this. Okay. And they push and they push. They don't do that. That's illegal. All
right. Oh, yeah, when
they skin the glove. It's called skinning the gloves.
Okay. They can't skin the gloves.
Yeah.
That's what a lot of Mexicans and stuff do. So yeah. Instead of it being an 8 ounce, it'd be like a 4 ounce.
Yeah.
Because all the air is pushed out of there.
Yeah. So if you see that, tell them no.
Flag that shit right
away. Flag it right away. And if the commission says something, then tell us so we can do it.
Yeah.
Here you go.
Here
you go right here. There we go. There we go.
Nice.
How do
you
hand
feel?
Can we
make a fist?
Yeah,
I
can make a fist.
Hold on.
Oh, yeah, I'm fucked this guy up.
Here
we go.
Yeah.
My man. All right, let me take it off.
Feeling the thunder right now. Ooh. Now I'm going to hit him with lightning.
Even the
I was watching Mayweather Corrales today.
Put on a clinic that fight.
Uh-huh.
He boxed, he punched.
Move. When he got close, dipped, came in. Grabbed him, turned him around, did the same thing again. Jab to the body, jab to the body. Faint, boom. I guess they just want to see where I'm at. You know what I'm saying? But this is a tough veteran. You know, it's not no wash. This guy's 34-1 with 23 knockouts, big puncher, Mexican style, come aggressive. You know, not a lot of people come into that after having their lungs blown out. You need a lot of conditioning for a fighter like that because it's just going to keep coming. And you have to be very strong-willed. So I know this is another test for me. You know, this is either going to make it or break it. And that really puts everything on the line. So I'm not overlooking nobody. I never did. I never will. You know, I know that there's always someone that's wanting to take what I have. You know, and I'll be damned if I let someone do that.
Jesus on that cross, I had to rise again. Time to get my blessings. Time to get my blessings. I had to live my life. I had to learn my lessons. I had to keep that smile, but deep inside I'm stressing. Was trying to keep my spirits from that deep depression. Time to tighten up. Put my pride down and pick that Bible up. Looking in the mirror, trying to find myself. Queen, she know I love her to this life and death. To get to the shop, jumping on the edge, plotting on the plan. Nothing without God, nothing without my fans. Sorry for my actions, hope y'all understand. No more we the best, callous.
So here we go. Failure. I think much could be revealed early on, considering how in the shocking loss to Cambosis. Teofimo Lopez had a 16-8 connected kick.
Short right drives down. A lot of blood coming from the nose of Campa. Headshot after headshot. Short right hand. A beat down in round 7. The take back. He just took what he wanted there in that round. And here it comes. Let the celebration begin. Old school Teofimo backflip. Junior welterweight champion, the Takeover.
If I gave you all of me, would I get all of you? If I told you I'm anointed, could you see the proof? Give my heart and soul for you when I'm inside the booth. Feel my love, feel my pain when I'm inside the booth. Would you switch a change on me if you knew the truth? Knowing I ain't the same. same person that was introduced. Thank the Lord, cause I don't look like what I've been through. Lord, here's a letter to you. I'm back again. Feeling so immortal.
I ain't get to see it, but listen. Packing up the seats. He looked fine, so I guess it went the way it's supposed to.
Yeah. Face was pretty clean.
I keep it real to the people. Ain't no lies coming out of the speakers. I gotta watch for the leeches. False prophets and the evil preachers come with normal features. I'm that different kind of a creature. I'm a fucking soldier. All my trials done made me stronger. Passion, I can't control it. Hating, I can't condone it. Something just gotta give. Don't listen, you gotta feel. Part of me had to die, so a part of me gets to live. Walking out on the label, I put aside all the fears. I'ma show all you niggas I do this shit here for real, on God.
Definitely thankful for everything that continues to happen. As y'all know, in Phoenix, I'm the top caterer. You see why, right? So, got some good stuff going on. Kind of got like a quick bite table.
Oh, to my baby, man, you know, yeah, he loves you to the fullest. You know, I do everything, going out my way, beating up my body, doing what I gotta do so that way we can teach you better ways. You don't have to go out there and follow people. You can be your own leader, be something like your dad is trying to do. You know, just be different, be you. You know, don't listen to nobody. You know, whatever you feel, do it, you know.
Everybody wants success. Only a few achieve.
You know, everything's gonna be all fine. It's gonna be fine no matter what. You know, everything happens for its reasons, and eventually you'll learn that, you'll know that. You know, I love you very much, my son. Just know that you have me and your grandfather mixed together, so you're unstoppable. And don't ever let someone stop that from you, because they can't. They're scared of you, if anything. I love you, my son, so much. Teofimo Liam Lopez.